Hello mọi người, xin chào mừng mọi người đến với kênh của mình. Hôm nay mình sẽ dẫn mọi người đi Universal Studio. Ok, đấy, mình đang trên đường đi. Và bây giờ mình ăn sáng. Đây là bên trong khuôn viên của Universal Studio.
Welcome to Universal Studios Hollywood. To assist with quickly entering the park, please place all belongings in the bins on a moving belt and proceed through the metal detector when directed by the security team. Don't forget to collect your items once you pass through the metal detector and enjoy your visit.
Cái tay long line hiểu không? You know what? đi đây. 230 thêm một vé nữa.
Khủng không?
Tôi mấy chục đồng thôi.
Hiện giờ thì chúng ta đang có mặt tại Super Nintendo World, một thế giới của Super Mario. À, đẹp không? Đó, thế giới của nấm di động. À, trò chơi mà lúc nhỏ mình thường hay chơi Mario. Có những con bông hoa ăn thịt người. Đó, những bông hoa ăn thịt người đây. Tuổi thơ của mình.
tiền để mua đồ ăn.
Hey, Mario.
Chờ bao nhiêu ăn từ đâu rồi đó. Đẹp không Ti?
Thank you.
it later when there's not a bit a lot of people.
Thank you.
bây giờ chúng ta sẽ ăn uống nghỉ ngơi trước khi tiếp tục khám phá các nơi ở phim trường. Bây giờ mình với em đi tìm mà chỗ ngồi ăn. Đứng đây đợi xem, đi xem phim trường người ta quay phim như thế nào, làm phim như thế nào nhé. Đó, giờ mình đang ở trên xe bus rồi nè, đi một vòng phim trường.
That's right. A few safety reminders to go over here as we do begin. First, if you need guest assistance,
scenes have been filmed right here.
Chart,
what have been your most memorable moments? I don't know. I mean, there's so many to choose from. You know, I'll know before yourself when Will first enters, and at that moment, his life changes forever. How about you? Well, the Valor Academy gym set is here too, and I'm moving ahead in that cold ice battle for hours.
These different interior scenes that they are talking about, they all filmed here on the studio lot. Stages 7, 8, also stage 14, which is currently on our left-hand side. Those are three permanent sound stages for the series Bel Air. When they are a permanent show, it just means they film here on a regular basis. They have filmed seasons 1 and 2 of Bel Air so far here on the studio lot. When they're filming those seasons, they will be here for multiple weeks, a couple of months at a time, filming the series. When they're in between seasons, sometimes they will put their sets in storage. Some of the shows aren't here on a regular basis. Sometimes shows are here for a few weeks. They film their episodes. They're out of here. They're only here part-time, temporarily. We don't have to just rent to our own productions. This is a big rental facility, open to all. So anyone is welcome. Any other type of production company can come rent these facilities. So we want these stages open and available as often as possible. Our co-host Jimmy Fallon, he films a show here on the studio lot, a game show. It's got singing involved, celebrities. It's called That's My Jam. Films here at Universal Studios Hollywood. That means Jimmy Fallon works on both coasts, sometimes in New York, filming the Tonight Show, sometimes here, working on other NBC projects. So we can film all of these interior scenes all at once. The sound stages help. Look left as we pull forward. There's a celebrity. Celebrity sighting. I see Ted, the teddy bear. Yeah, you recognize Ted? Ted and Ted too. It's just Ted. He's hanging out. You know, Ted is returning to Peacock in the near future. He's coming back as a streaming series, not a TV series, a streaming series. It's going to be a prequel to the two movies. The series will take place in the 1990s. They're filming here on the studio lot. Season 1, we'll show you a location or two later that Ted has been using. The front lot is a lot where a lot of filming takes place. It's also where pre-production work happens, post-production work. That includes some of the office work that goes along with filming. We have some offices on your left. These bungalows, they serve as such for different directors, writers, producers. It's over here where you'd find the home of Illumination Entertainment. They make animated movies for us, like the new Super Mario Brothers movie that's been in theaters. Here's the office of the late Mr. Alfred Hitchcock, bungalow 5195. They have his famous silhouette still painted on the outside, next to the doorway there. We're going to be hitting our back lot soon. Nathan's going to be driving us through a lot of our exterior sets. We can go anywhere in the world here on our back lot. We'll prove it to you here in a few moments. We're going to be in the back lot soon, but we've got two more sound stages to showcase on your left here before we leave the front lot completely behind. These two stages are state-of-the-art. They're new, they're nice, they're in use by two different NBC shows. One of the shows is George Lopez's new show. He's on NBC with a series called Lopez vs. Lopez that co-stars his real-life daughter. They film some of that series, interior scenes, in stage 25. And the stage that's right next to us now, stage 26, this one's used for a series called American Auto. It's based around a fictional Detroit car company. It airs on NBC. So a lot of our shows are the permanent ones, but anyone is welcome to rent out these facilities. What they really like to rent sometimes is our backlot space, some of these exterior sets. This is one of the many areas you're getting a glimpse of here on your right. Our metropolitan area, we can recreate any big city out here, whether that's New York, Boston, Chicago, San Francisco, Los Angeles, if need be. Take a look at this street here on your right. This is Brownstone Street. See if you can recognize it from this scene I'll play from the movie Bruce Almighty. So we'll reuse these locations over and over and over again. We try to change the looks of them. We don't have to change them very much. We change them slightly, so hopefully you don't recognize them between different movies or different television shows. Sometimes areas are iconic. Sometimes areas are too recognizable. It's just too hard to cover up what they have been used for before. Maybe like this area here on our left might be the most recognizable spot on our tour today. Courthouse Square, we would know it as Hill Valley from the Back to the Future trilogy. 1955 Hill Valley, 1985, even the distant futuristic year of 2015. It was all done right here on our left. Technically, that is the same courthouse building that you're looking at that was used for Back to the Future. It looks different now than it did back then, but that's done on purpose because we don't want you to know these locations are exactly the same places. You're seeing more examples on your screens right now, other feature films that have worked right here in Courthouse Square. If you want a more recent example, we've got a Peacock series that streams called Rutherford Falls. They turn this area into their fictional courthouse town, their small fictional town from Rutherford Falls. That streams on Peacock, seasons 1 and 2. So we can have small areas like Hill Valley. We can also take it to the big city as well, like New York. We're turning on to New York Street. My co-host Jimmy Fallon is no stranger to New York City. He hosts the Tonight Show there, so we'll check in with him, see what he's got to say about what it's like to work in a place like this.
Hey everyone, welcome to New York! I got my start right here in New York on Saturday Night Live. This is actually my old neighborhood. What's got mugged over there? An old woman. Tough lady. This is my favorite hot dog guy. Hey, buddy. How's it going? Remember me?
No.
Just like old times. Gotta love New York City.
I'm walking here.
You're busy rolling.
It's cool, guys. I was just, just walking there. So it's not exactly New York, but a lot of times when you see New York in the movies, it was shot right here on the Universal Metro sets. If you can make it here, you can make it anywhere.
The main thing to keep in mind with these backlot buildings, they're not really buildings at all. Most of them are just facades. They have all four exterior walls, but a lot of them don't have interior space. We don't waste our time building what the camera is not going to see.
Sau đây là cảnh King Kong và khủng long đánh với nhau. Sẽ được chiếu trên màn hình hai bên.
At the very last moment, when the right time is to go ahead and put those 3D glasses on.
The Universal Tram is
mình quay thì sẽ không được thật lắm, nhưng mà khi ngồi ở đây thì sẽ có cảm giác rất là thật. Bị hất tung, bị
đẩy ra. Bây giờ là chờ. You're welcome to take photos once we arrive. We ask you to turn the flash off on your cameras. The flash makes King Kong angry. We don't want to do that. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back
to King Kong.
Oh,
Sau đây là những cảnh, những chiếc xe trong phim. Đó, những chiếc xe có trong phim.
We have some prehistoric cars, some Flintstones vehicles. Those run on more than just foot power. They have little motors hidden inside. Of course, we gotta have some cars from our biggest franchises. There's a couple cars down here from the Jurassic series. I think you'll recognize the gyrosphere there if you've seen the newer movies, like Jurassic World, Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom. There's something missing from that gyrosphere that you might remember from the films. It's the glass, it's the sphere, you know, it's what makes it a gyrosphere. Truthfully, all of that glass was done with visual effects, all done with CGI, computer-generated imagery. Glass can cause a lot of problems with reflections. They just decided, forget it, do it with visual effects, and no one's gonna be able to tell the difference. I guess we do have some of the dinosaurs still stored out here. Never know when you might need them for another Jurassic Park movie. You? We're sorry about that, folks. We had no idea that was about to happen. We had no idea at all. You know, speaking of water effects, speaking of weather, that is sometimes used in movies like Jurassic Park. The weather can help set the right mood, the right tone for a specific scene. In fact, they were using weather in that scene that we were just talking about from The Lost World involving the mobile lab. There are rain effects being used to try and create the right ominous tone. That can be our problem here in sunny Southern California. You know, we don't always get the right type of weather that we might need for a certain production. We get the same boring sunshine day in and day out. So sometimes we have to create our own weather here on the back lot. We can have different types of weather happening in different areas all at the same time, if need be. Well, right now Nathan has brought us here to this part.
Đó, bây giờ qua cảnh mưa lũ nha các bạn.
This area is rigged up for a weather demonstration. We're going to show you how we can create a thunderstorm at any time of day.
Sấm chớp nè. Sấm chớp xong rồi sẽ có mưa.
We've also brought up speakers out here so you can hear the sound effects, so you can hear the thunder. And we're going to go ahead and get the water effect started on your left-hand side too. It's not hard to create rain, at least here in Old Mexico. We just have sprinklers hooked to the top of some of those telephone poles. It shoots the water into the air and it just falls back down to earth naturally. We do try and use a bigger raindrop than normal, so it has the best chance to appear on screen. You could be watching a sporting event, you know, a football game, and the announcers will talk about how it's raining on the field, but on television it can be hard to see that rain appear. We want to make sure it shows up.
Đằng xa có nước lũ tràn tới.
Amanda Bynes and Paul Giamatti. We are crossing the border on our studio tour, leaving Old Mexico, entering the Old West. This part of our lot is known as Six Points, Texas. It has that name because during the heyday of the Western genre, there used to be six different Western streets out here. They all came together at a central hub. So we named the place Six Points, Texas. Yeah, we're that creative here in the industry. Six Points is one of the most historic spots you'll find on the back lot. We've been filming the Western genre longer than anything else, and we still use this area to this day, every so often. It got used for Quentin Tarantino's latest movie, Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, starring Brad Pitt and Leonardo DiCaprio. All three of those stars were here during the making of the movie. If you recall, Leonardo DiCaprio is an actor in the film. He gets cast in a Western production. All the scenes they filmed for that supposed Western series were filmed here in Six Points, Texas. Another one of our NBC shows, Quantum Leap, That's an old one that's been revived. It's back on NBC with new episodes. It's a show about time travel, so they film all over the studio lot. One of their episodes takes them to the Old West. They film it here in Six Points. They do have to make a couple changes to the area when they film an offensive being built here on the studio lot. And to tell us more about one of the shows that films over there, Kelly Clarkson.
Hey, what's up, Studio Tour? I'm Kelly Clarkson from The Voice, and we shoot our show right here in Stage 31, one of the newest stages on the lot, actually. These state-of-the-art sound stages allow us to bring our show to life from the blinds, to the lights, and everything in between. The Voice.
They actually just came back. They're filming now season 25, the blind auditions of season 25 of The Voice, currently filming right now here at Universal Studios Hollywood. So we've always got something happening. This is an active movie studio, and we've got some historical sets, but we've also got some active filming locations. Our sound stages are in use more than ever. So we've got some new sound stages. The Voice, one of those shows, being filmed. We're going to take it to another part of the world here. Now that we've made it to the other end of our backlog, the other end of our property, we're going to drive you through our Little Europe sets. Little Europe. It's because this area is normally dressed as a European city or country. It was built in the 1920s, built for the Hunchback of Notre Dame. Then it got used for All Quiet on the Western Front. That was Universal's first Oscar winner for Best Picture in 1930. That decade of the 30s, this is where the Universal monsters got their start. Guys like Frankenstein, Dracula, the Wolfman, the Invisible Man, the Mummy. They love to film their angry villager scenes, among others, here in our Little Europe sets. This area got a lot of fame because of those movies. Keep in mind, we're still talking about facades out here. These buildings are just the exterior walls. You can see through some of the windows. You can see there is not all that much happening on the inside. In fact, these buildings will be made out of more lightweight materials. It's not necessarily real brick, real stone. Sometimes it's just plastic, fiberglass. That way it's a lot easier for us to come in and change it around, make it look different. These sets stand the test of time, but they don't stand just based on their historical value alone. We need to be able to reuse these sets again and again in the future. Little Europe got used extensively for one of our NBC shows called The Good Place, starring Ted Danson and Kristen Bell. That show takes place in the afterlife. It literally takes place in The Good Place. And who knew that The Good Place looked just like Little Europe here on the Universal Studio backlot? That's convenient. That's convenient. Let me show you what The Good Place looked like on screen.
You, Eleanor Shellstrom, are dead.
Cool.
This location, the afterlife. I have never ever seen this. You're in the good place.
I'm not supposed to be here. I can't risk going to the bad place.
Hey, well, maybe it's not all that bad.
Hi there. How can I help you?
What is the bad place like?
Well, it doesn't sound awesome.
The Good Place ran for 5 seasons. It was another one of our permanent shows. So they filmed here all the time. Made sense for them to film a lot of their exterior scenes right here on the studio backlot. This is actually a little bit of a unique route for our studio tour. Normally, we drive through Soundstage 50, but inside there is under construction right now. They're doing some refurbishment work inside of Soundstage 50. So a little detour down Denver Street, another one of our western areas here on the backlot. In fact, it's over here on the left-hand side, up here on this hill. This is where we had the very first live audience here at Universal Studios. You know, our founder, Carl Laemmle, even 100 years ago, always had a vision and idea that people wanted to see behind the scenes of movie making. That this was an interesting aspect of the whole movie process. So we had 100 years ago in the 1920s, bleachers, grandstands built upon this hill, and then guests could come in for the day and watch the Western movies being filmed down below on Denver Street, some of the other roads. So yeah, 1920s. Right here on this grandstand. This was the very first location. And 100 years later, hey, we're still doing something like it. We just got a little bit more modern tram to take us around the studio lot. I say a little bit more modern. It's, you know, it's an old vehicle.
Còn sắp tới đây là cảnh cái sâu, cái mập. Cái mập chung phải cái sâu. Cái mập ăn thịt người. Đó, cảnh trong phim phim cá mập anh. Ở đây đó đằng xa xa là con cá mập đang bơi, thấy không, cái đuôi cá mập không, cái đó một ông thợ lặn đã bị ăn Rồi, chỉ còn một vũng máu. Rất thật cảnh thẳng qua tái hiện lại cảnh trong phim cá mập. Cái này là cái hồ, làm cái hồ giống cái hồ trong phim. Đó, bắt đầu chú ý có một con cá mập đó.
He was named Bruce during the filming. Steven Spielberg named him after his attorney, Bruce Raymer. That is still his attorney to this day, so at least the guy could take a joke. The filming with Bruce did not go as planned. The shark was a real problem. They took the shark on location. They filmed in the Atlantic Ocean. They first tested the shark in fresh water. They took him to the salt water of the sea. He reacted differently. They corroded a lot of the wiring inside. On the very first day of filming for Jaws, Bruce sank to the bottom of the Atlantic Sea. It prompted the crew to nickname the troubled production Flaws. It ended up delaying the release of the movie by over 150 days. Jaws was supposed to be a Christmas-time movie in 1974, but instead it was released in the summertime of 1975, which probably worked out a lot better for Universal, having a movie like Jaws be released during the summer months. Jaws was the first movie to make $100 million at the box office. That was a big deal in 1975. Nowadays, it's all about the billion-dollar mark, with a B. Can your movie make $1 billion? We've had a few billion-dollar movies in our lifetime. You know, the dinosaurs of Jurassic World have done it, Fast and Furious has done it. The Minions, they've made $1 billion in just one movie. Some of the homes have been remodeled, some new colors of paint, but not all that much. Not all that much is different. A lot of the homes are eerily similar. We don't have to change these buildings up too much, we don't think, in order to be able to continue to reuse them. This street was used before the Housewives moved in. It's been used since the Housewives have moved out. In fact, just the third season of a Netflix series just got released. Never Have I Ever. It's produced by Mindy Kaling. All three seasons of that show have used this street. And season three just came out on Netflix. So, Never Have I Ever from Mindy Kaling. You might recognize some of these homes. If you've watched the movie in the last few years, Why Him, starring Bryan Cranston and James Franco, that movie filmed here on this street. I like mentioning it because there's a scene where it snows during that movie. The movie is set in Michigan. It snows during one of the scenes. They bring in fake snow. Everyone wears winter coats. They make it look like it's freezing outside. That scene was filmed during the month of May. It was a very warm week at that as well. So I guess that's why they gotta pay the actors the big bucks, you know, that's why they make so much money, because they gotta fake it, they gotta make it look legitimate. It could be a warm summer Southern California day, but it's freezing, it's literally freezing in the scene, they gotta make it look believable, so that's why they get paid so much to do what they do. In fact, we don't call this street Wisteria Lane here on the back lot, you know, we call it Colonial Street, an average name since it's an average suburban neighborhood. You wouldn't see it called Colonial Street in a given production, just its back lot name. Similar to how we call them New York Street or Six Points, Texas, Denver Street, Little Europe. Just another name for that average location that we've got. We've shown you a lot of the mundane spaces. That's what we like to have most of here at Universal Studios. That's what gets used most often here on our lot, other than sound stages. If you are a fan of thrillers, if you're a fan of classics, if you know Alfred Hitchcock, I bet you know this next set. Of course, we're talking about Psycho. We're coming up on the Bates Motel, the Psycho House. It's on the hill. 12 rooms, 12 vacancies. There's also an office on the far left-hand side. Oh, and take a look at that. There's the one and only Norman Bates right now. He's working at the motel himself. He just stepped out.
Rồi, sau đây cũng là một cảnh đặc sắc nữa. Đó, một người đàn ông mở cốp xe ra chuẩn bị đem bước vào nhà nè.
12 rooms, there's 150 of us. I hate to say it, some of us are gonna have to double.
Đó, người đàn ông khiêng cái xác ra. Một cảnh giết người.
Guys, do you see this?
Giấu xác à. Một cảnh ở trong phim kinh dị, phim giết người. Đàn ông giết người đó. Giờ giấu xác cho cấp xe rồi. Rồi giờ đã phát hiện ra có người nhìn thấy người đàn ông đang tiến tới. Rồi sau đây sẽ là cảnh máy bay bị rơi. Cái xác máy bay trước mặt các bạn là cái xác máy bay đã bị rơi.
Weeks to construct the set, another week of filming on it, all for just 4 minutes worth of camera time in the movie. That's in 4 minutes worth of War of the Worlds. But hey, on the airplane, they did a real airplane evacuation, which I think is kind of cool as well, meaning that those real background actors, they did not plan ahead of time, they didn't rehearse, they didn't say, you know, okay, this is exactly how the airplane evacuation is gonna go. They all got onto the plane, and then they literally had them do an airplane evacuation and then just filmed it. And then they just filmed it for a portion of that scene. Let's watch it one more time. Again, keep in mind, this all.
I'm the reason we just lost control of this whole operation. My name is Special Agent Lou Collins of the U.S. Department of Homeland Security. And I'm here to tell you that the U.S. Diplomatic Security Service, and as of 16.9 seconds ago, I'm the man in charge.
The hell you are?
Let me clue you in on two things, sweet cheeks. One, there's a high-value witness from the Federal Protection Program aboard your vehicle. And two, International Crime Syndicate led by Owen Shaw is honing in on this vehicle to take that witness out. Shaw's as ruthless as a gun. He'll stop at nothing to eliminate his target. Every living soul on this vehicle is in serious danger. Other than that, enjoy the ride.
This is not your jurisdiction.
It is now, stink pickle.
I'm so tired of you stink guys stepping in. Just whatever you feel like.
You do.
Don't you.
That's better. We're moving your vehicle to a safe location until we have the situation under control.
Everybody out. The FBI. Present the intercom.
Ladies, let's just back up a little bit. I got you. Slightly. First of all, I don't work for you.
Oh, really? Well, tell me, Roman, who do you work for?
We don't work for nobody. Cops are just clear out of here, otherwise we can't guarantee your safety.
Guarantee my safety? I'm the one holding the gun.
Yeah, but mine's a whole lot bigger than yours. Cops, escort this novice out.
Let's go, Cookie Puss!
You got an ugly suit on, man. It's cheap.
Somebody out there really pissed off Shaw. It's gonna get ugly fast.
Yeah, don't worry. Lucky for you, our whole family will protect you.
Are you kidding me, Roman? You didn't shut off your phone, bro?
I gotta call you back. I'm in the middle of the cycle.
Is he talking about?
Call you back.
Man.
It was on vibrate. Shaw tricked us. Ops can't hold him forever. Lenny? Roman, we're up. Driver, move that vehicle.
It's about to get real interesting. I'm on the lease.
gangsters all warmed up right next door.
Robin, grab your truck. I need you and Les ready to roll.
Thì đi chờ đi xem show. Ở đây rất là đông người đang đợi đợi xem show diễn ở trên nước. Mời mọi người cùng mình xem đây là show diễn gì nhé. Show diễn rất là đông người, các hàng ghế đều kín và show diễn mọi người phải chuẩn bị áo mưa nha, vì sẽ bị ướt như thế này. Cái chân đã bị dính nước, bị tạt nước. Đó bên kia. Mọi người phải chuẩn bị áo mưa, những thứ cần thiết để khỏi bị ướt. À, đây là khung cảnh, quang cảnh. Xem hết show các bạn sẽ
Yes. Brothers and sisters. Hey, David. You hear that? These are not your brothers and sisters. These are my people. Come on, run!
Somebody shoot him up.
And he has told me personally that someone here knows a way to dry land. That's on my plot, dry land. We're going to pave it and drive it, tax it and dive it. Sweet. Joe Thorpe, he's a cruiser for the truck. We're going to 18 on my way to my road.
Something. Look up there. Chuck, give me a weapon.
Hey, boss. I'm up there.
Yeah, try to.
What's wrong with this? Oh, shut up! Oops. Enough fun and games. I need something with a little bit of a teeth. I want to see the tear runs down my teeth. Get up. Someone signal my seat. So is it worth it? See that ladder? Start climbing. Woo! I got a brand new vision. A pilgrimage for two to dry land. I'll think about it, Helen.
Thank you.